What's up guys? I know most of you subscribe because of the ESP8266 videos, and don't worry, I will do more projects with that board, I'm just very busy right now. In the last video I showed you how I made the magnet rotors for the wind turbine. Here's a picture of one of them with the cured resin that I promised I will show you in this video. Today I will show you the coil winding process. Okay, so here's the coil winder I built with some scrap metal, two pieces of all-thread and one aluminum tube for the handle. The scrap pieces of wood measure about 5 cm or about 2 inches. The small wood block in the middle, it's just a bit smaller than the magnets and is 1.3 cm thick or about half an inch. I used a little digital counter to keep track of the turns. I soldered two cables to the button pads and used a micro switch so it counts every full turn. Those metal rods I'm using are sticks from an old tent that I had laying around. To hold the copper spool, I just use a broom that I stole from a witch that conveniently was flying by and put it in a bucket. I use a candle to create a thin layer of wax on all the parts that contact the coil. The reason for this is because I use superglue to hold the coil layers together, and this prevents the copper from getting glued to the winder. I cut two slots in opposing sides of the coil winder to stick the wire so when I finish a coil I can twist the ends of each one together and remove it safely without losing its shape, but more to that later. I use a spatula to help align the copper. I cover it with electrical tape to avoid scratching the enamel of the wire. To begin with the winding process, I made a 90 degree turn and stuck the wire in the slot. Make sure to leave about 15 cm or 6 inches of copper so you can solder it later to another coil when making the stator. My wind turbine will consist of 9 coils with 70 turns each, a 14 gauge or 1.6 mm thick enameled copper wire. The first coil took me about 35 minutes, but I kept getting faster and the last only took about 10 minutes. Every 2 to 3 layers I used a drop of superglue to hold the coil together. In the end of the winding process, I twisted the wires I talked about earlier, the silver ones, together. I also twisted the beginning and the end of the coil together. I removed the rods. I took off the front wooden square and took off the coil. This was my first coil, so it was not perfect. The other ones turned out quite a lot better. To finish, I removed the silver wires and used cloth tape. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe. And if you have any question, make sure to leave it in the comments. Have fun!